so decided. And we start by understanding that this next chapter of development cannot fall victim to the old divides between developed nations and developing ones. Poverty, growing inequality exists in all of our nations, and all of our nations have work to do.
The SDGs are meant not just for governments, very clearly they're meant for our society as a whole. Each corporation can say, well, here's a list of things that we ought to be thinking about. Some corporations, almost all corporations, ought to be thinking about the environmental goals. They also ought to be thinking, are they treating their workers fairly?
I think that the SDGs are a historic opportunity. It's the first time that an intergovernmental process has produced metrics. So the degree of ownership is extraordinary. So rather than complaining or trying to see how you can make it even better or more perfect, we should just recognize that what came out of New York is quite remarkable, and that everybody's appetite now is for implementation, and that it's no longer just governments. Look at the New York Declaration on Forests. It was private sector signing on to that. So private sector, civil society, everybody's ready to start to implement. I think that's where the conversation has to be now. How do we actually do it?
Even if this link is not obvious immediately, it is clear. Research shows that people living in cities where they have green area are less stressed and less sick than people living in cities where there is no green. And if you want to maintain life on land, and then if you have forest representing 80% of the terrestrial biodiversity, you need to maintain healthy forest and healthy tree landscape. So I think that's the role of research for me, is really showing the various trade-offs and providing the various analysis and data that show that, you may not be able to do everything everywhere, but in this place, this is what research or what science tells you, that's the best you can do.
The big challenges in achieving the SDGs is going to be to understand the interplays between top-down policy making, or policy making at least at the high level, and implementation by all of humanity on the ground.
I don't think you're ever going to achieve global targets without aligning those local needs to national commitments to the targets.
Actually, with the SDGs, they're still looking for ways to measure these targets and things, and there's probably a lot of overlap between the sort of tools we're likely to use in a landscape approach and the sort of tools we're likely to use for the SDGs. It's really time to put theory into practice and test to see if it's going to work.
So by having a global development agenda that really highlights and prioritizes the importance of gender equality and women's rights on its own terms, and not because it will lead to other instrumental benefits, I think it has a lot to add to the way in which we understand and appreciate the value of forests, both for people and for the environment.
How can you really engage the thousands of farmers and smallholders who are being asked to change their behavior and need to actually benefit from some of these higher level processes if we're actually going to have these development and environmental outcomes that we're hoping for?